Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of AP World History in 516. Today's video is all about giving you three easy steps in order to make your writing better. All right, so the first tip is eliminating contractions. All right, and one of the ways that I think that we can really show this is by taking a look at what academic writing looks like in other contexts to be able to show, like, people don't write like this in academic settings. They don't use contractions like can't, won't, shouldn't, things like that. So I've got a Britannica.com article pulled up here about John Locke. John Locke is someone that we take a look at in Unit 5, so it makes sense to kind of use something like that. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a Control F here for any sort of contractions. All right, and you'll notice already that apostrophes show up. There's about 15 of them here on this screen page, but what I want to emphasize is that these aren't contractions. These are different. So if you take a look, locks, that is not a contraction, just showing ownership. Another one, locks, enlightenment. All right. We'll go down to this one, countries, again, not a contraction. Locks, not a contraction. Locks, locks, locks. All right. You get the picture here. And one of the things that I think is really clear with academic writing is that contractions take away from your writing. If you look at any sort of academic writing, contractions really don't exist at all. So one easy way that you can improve your writing is by eliminating contractions. Now we're on to tip number two, and that is condensing your writing. It is so critical in your writing to eliminate any sort of wasted words. If you think about it in the context of an AP test where you're in a timed writing environment, you want every word to have purpose and meaning. But if you're using words like very, or if you're repeating words like millions and millions and millions, when you could just say millions of and then whatever you're talking about. And I think what this does is two things. One, it just makes your writing better. It's tighter, it's more focused. And then two, again, that gives you more time to be able to get those points on the AP rubric. The third tip to improve your writing is eliminating pronouns. And as you see on the screen here, I've got a list of various types of pronouns. One of the things that you need to start eliminating is using especially things like I, you, he, she, they, them. Because if you're a reader and you say, "He did this," well, I have no idea who you're talking about. Now, even if you've already mentioned, say, an author or a group of people by saying, like, he, she, them, or they, I can make those assumptions about who you're talking about. But if you're incorporating multiple people within a paragraph and you just use this blanket pronoun of he or she, I'm left wondering, who are you talking about? All right, so the last easy step that you can do to make your writing better is to just use the author's last name instead of using any sort of pronoun. It makes your writing better, it makes it cleaner, and it addresses any sort of clarity issues about who you're actually talking about. All right, so those are my three quick and easy tips to help improve your writing. Now, if you like the video, I would appreciate a like, as well as if you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Just as an update right now, we're just a couple of subscriptions shy of reaching that 100 subscription goal, where once we reach that, I'll do a live stream of Minecraft. So keep pushing, and thank you to everybody who has already subscribed and for all of the support. It's much appreciated. Thanks, guys.